So speaking of granted, we'd never take you for granted, sir. Welcome back. We have a lot of questions today.
Good.
I want to get to this one because it says, Carlos says, I'm 68 years old. I have an itch on my back and my chest from within. What do you think this is, and what can this person take?
First of all, this is not an uncommon problem, Ron, and it's difficult to sleuth it out the detective would. However, there are some good things to start. First of all, avoid hot showers. Try to keep cool if possible. Use oral antihistamines like diphenhydramine, Benadryl is the brand name, or cetirizine, brand name is Zyrtec. Those might help as well. Sometimes it's necessary to go to a dermatologist, and sometimes even the dermatologist can't figure out what's going on.
Yeah, the skin is a finicky...
It is.
Is the skin the organ?
The largest organ in the body.
Thank you. I meant to say that. All right. After having my teeth cleaned, fluoride paste was applied to all of my teeth. Is this safe?
First of all, it's not only safe, but it's recommended. It helps prevent cavities, and as we age, of course, there are less cavities, but there are still cavities. So I get fluoride myself, and I recommend it to all patients who go through their dental office.
Okay. This is a very important question. Is there any prevention for Alzheimer's if you have two parents with Alzheimer's?
The best prevention for Alzheimer's is to keep that brain active. So doing Sudoku, doing crossword puzzles, keeping socially active with conversation with other people, challenging your brain at any chance is a way to help prevent Alzheimer's. There's a lot of research that needs to be done on Alzheimer's to help us learn more. But at this time, that's about what we can offer.
Okay, this caller says, I was denied for an MRI. When does the doctor have the opportunity to support his patient?
This is a difficult one.
Yeah.
At this point, it's hard for a third party, an outside entity, mm-hmm. to know everything that the doctor is thinking, but MD means that they've had 8 years of experience, and they should know when to do diagnostic tests so they're not frivolous. There are data that show Hawaii is not overly excessive in the ordering of screening tests such as CT and MRI. So I think we should trust the doctor.
Okay, last question. Are probiotics good for everyone? What's the difference between raw and the pill form?
This is an early field, the use of probiotics. It's been used for a long time, but scientific evidence for it is still lacking. So we think that probiotics are probably good for people. We don't think that they're bad for people. It depends on whether you're selling the raw form, such as yogurt, for mm-hmm. example, as to whether you would say get that or get a pill form, which is easier to take. But at this point, we don't have data on which is more effective.
Good to know.
They are effective for gastrointestinal illnesses in particular, and there's nothing wrong with them.
A lot of doctors say they're big fans of yogurt.
Big fans.
Do you do yogurt?
I do.
Do you do yoga?
I don't.
Thanks, Doc. Have a great weekend.
Thank you.